Yes, hello everyone. Yes, somebody please ping me if I'm audible so that I can start the session. Good evening, Jayashree. Good evening, Kiruba. Good evening, Kajal. Okay, thank you. Hello everyone. Welcome to Unacademy, India's largest online learning platform. Let's crack UPSC CSE English. Now, before I start the session, let me introduce myself for the people who are new on the platform or who are attending my session for the first time. My name is Alok Oja. I have done my engineering from Pune. I have been associated with the field of UPSC since past 6 to 6.5 years. I have been through various stages of civil services exam. I hold the experience of giving serious SSB twice. I also hold the experience of exams like CAPF, Assistant Commandant and Uttar Pradesh PSC. I'm involved into the field of teaching since past 5 years and I have mentored more than 10,000 students for UPSC. Now, we are going for a series of revolutionaries, that is Indian Revolutionary, and this is part two of the topic. Again, with a very dynamic and very dynamic and interesting part of the Indian Revolutionaries. Now, there might be a question in the mind of an aspirant why one should prefer Unacademy as a platform for online learning. So here are the ample of reasons why one should prefer Unacademy as a platform for online learning. First of all, you'll have daily live classes on the Unacademy platform. Unacademy offers you assimilation of top and dynamic educators of India on a single platform. You can directly interact with the educators. You can clear all sorts of doubts with the educators. Secondly, one of the most important aspects for an aspirant who is preparing for civil services is basically developing competence or competitiveness. Now, why competence or competitiveness is important? Because an aspirant is not only competing with the fellow aspirant in the district, he is competing on pan-India basis. And that is why he needs to develop that sort of competence or competitiveness. And Unacademy helps you to build up your competence or competitiveness by going through live tests and quizzes. All the courses on Unacademy platform are highly structured in nature and there is a proper timetable through which the courses are being conducted. And one can have unlimited access to the courses on Unacademy platform. Here are the few top and dynamic educators of India from whom you're going to learn through. These are the courses being offered on the Unacademy platform. Subscribe to Unacademy and use my code AKOUS. I repeat the code AKOUS. Now, there is also something called as iconic subscription. Now, what is basically iconic subscription all about? Suppose you are preparing for civil services and you are a beginner basically. Now, initially, a beginner usually faces a lots of hindrances while preparing for civil services. Like what timetable that needs to be followed, what strategy needs to be followed, how much time should be dedicated to read the current affairs, which government magazine should be read, how much time should be dedicated to read each GS paper, how an optional subject needs to be chosen, then what is the pattern of answer writing, because answer writing plays a very crucial role in the mains exam. Reason behind that is the only piece of interaction between you and the examiner is your answer. So answer writing is basically an art. So there would be a mentor who would be guiding you throughout your journey for civil services preparation. So if you choose me as your mentor, please use my code AKOUS. I repeat the code AKOUS. Good evening, Anshu. Good evening, Yogesh. Good evening, Rituparna. Good evening, Apurva. Good evening, Kaushik. Good evening, RJ. Good evening, Shashank. Good evening, Shipra. Okay, guys. So now let's get started with the part two of the Indian Revolutionary. Now, before I start with the part two of the Indian Revolutionary, let me give you a brief background about how the revolutionary movement basically gained a pace in India. Now, let me go to the genesis of Congress basically. So that basically one can easily understand the revolutionary activities that were cropping up in India at this point of time. Okay, now Indian National Congress was formed at a place called as Gokuldas Tejpal Sanskrit College in Bombay. It was formed in 1885, and the first session of the Indian National Congress was presided by Vomesh Chandra Banerjee. It was attended by 72 delegates basically. And it is said that in the first session, basically, every section of the Indian society was represented for the first time. Second session of the Indian National Congress was presided by this grand old man of India, whose name was Dadabhai Nauroji. And it was attended by 436 delegates. Third session of the Indian National Congress was attended by Badruddin Tayabji. Right from the formation of the Indian National Congress, it was basically divided into two ideologies right from the start. One was moderates and the other was extremists. Moderates believed in steadiness. They believed in patience. They believed that we want to gain independence, but not all of a sudden. We want independence in a gradual stage by stage manner. Secondly, they believed in patience. Now, it is said that basically their activities were cornered around three P's. I repeat, their activities were cornered around three P's. That is prayer, protest and petition. And they believe that even if we have to go for a peaceful protest, it should be within the constitutional limit. But extremists were exactly opposed to this. And extremists believe that basically we need to go beyond the constitutional limit to gain independence for India. And they never believed in maintaining loyalty towards the Britishers. In fact, they believed that Britishers are unworthy of our loyalty. Now, in 1905, Lord Curzon announced the partition of Bengal on the pretext of it was too big to be administered. But the hidden intention of Lord Curzon was to divide India on the communal lines. West Bengal was a Hindu majority area and East Bengal was a Muslim majority area. So he wanted to disturb the communal harmony in India. And against this step of partitioning the Bengal, a movement was started in India that is referred as Swadeshi movement. And the call for Swadeshi movement was given at Banaras session of Indian National Congress, which was presided by Gopal Krishna Gokhale. Now this movement became very successful in the region of Bengal and it spread to other parts of India as well. Now basically, there came up a new section which is referred as Indian Revolutionary. Now, this section was dissatisfied with the policy and the methods of moderates as well as extremists. They believed that neither the moderates nor the extremists had gained something substantial for India from the British government. And now, the revolutionaries believed only in one major concept. And their concept was eye for an eye strategy. There have been peaceful protests against the British rule during various movements. But each and every time, our Indian leaders were subject to insult, were subject to humiliation and being beaten up by the police in a very brutal manner. So we did not have the same respect in our own motherland, basically. So these revolutionaries were inspired from the outside events as well. Like basically, they were inspired from Russian nihilist. We have discussed about this yesterday. They were inspired from various countries like Ireland as well. Secondly, they believed in revolutionary thoughts. And one of the major reason here was, for years, we have been peacefully protesting against the Britishers. And we have got nothing as a part of substantial returns. Basically, although there was passage of Indian Council Act 1892, although there was passage of Morley-Minto reforms 1909, although there was passage of Montagu-Chelmsford reform, but the power of the British rule remained the same. It was reflected that Indians were given more power, but actually Indians were not given any sort of power because majority of the power lies in the hands of Britishers. So they came up with various activities, Indian Revolutionary. And one of the major methodology was running secret society. Okay, secret societies were not only run in India. Secret societies were run even outside India. In places like Berlin, Vancouver, which is in Canada, San Francisco, which is in USA. So basically Paris, which is in France. Like Madam Kama, she is also referred as Mother of Indian Revolutionary. She was an expert in bomb making and she used to train all the revolutionary in the training of making the bombs. So, this majorly the revolutionary came from Punjab, UP, Bihar, Bengal, Madras and Maharashtra. And various secret societies cropped up around 1950 to 1925. And various revolutionary activity that was gaining pace by now. Like, one of the activity was assassination of unpopular officials. In fact, even women were involved in these activities. Now, I had given example yesterday about two women basically. Shanti Ghosh and Suniti Chaudhary. They were hardly 15 to 14 years, but the courage shown by them was very exemplary. Now, it is said that they assassinated a British officer by going into his office. So, such an exemplary courage was shown by the Indian revolutionary. Like Anant Lakshman Kanhere, he was involved in Nasik conspiracy case and they assassinated basically district collector of Nasik whose name was Jackson. And Savarkar brothers were involved in the entire plot here. So yesterday we had discussed about the various revolutionary activities. Today we had discussed about Bengal and Maharashtra. Today we are going to discuss about Punjab, UP and Bihar. My friends, did you get the background? Please let me know. Any query, any question, any sort of doubt. Good evening, Shishir. Good evening, Sonali. Good evening, Ram Kumar. Okay, now let's start with the associations that were formed in the region of Punjab, UP and Bihar. Hindustan Republic Association. Now it was basically founded in Kanpur and major role was played by Ram Prasad Bismil, Jogesh Chandra Chatterjee and Sachin Sanyal. With the coming years, Hindustan leaders like Bhagat Singh and Chandrasekhar Azad also got associated with Hindustan Republic Association, which was later merged with Hindustan Socialist Republic Association. So initially it was formed by Ram Prasad Bismil and major and the key founder of this association was Ram Prasad Bismil ji. And the main aim was armed revolution to overthrow the colonial rule. Now, as I've talked about the activities and the methodologies of moderates and the extremists, it is said that revolutionaries were highly dissatisfied by the methodologies that was adopted by moderates and extremists both. And every time a movement was being conducted in India, it was very brutally suppressed. I'll give you a very small example. Like non-cooperation movement, which was started in 1920 by M.K. Gandhi, was based on twin pillars. And the twin pillars were non-violence, that is ahimsa, and Satyagraha. And the entire movement was run on the principle of ahimsa. But after the Chauri Chaura incident, basically, the non-cooperation movement was taken back by M.K. Gandhi. After that, British came up heavily on the Satyagrahis. British suppressed the movement in a very brutal manner. Another example of civil disobedience movement. Like basically it is said that Britishers confiscated the property of Satyagrahi. Like if students participated in a peaceful protest, fines were imposed on the student. Scholarship of the students was cancelled. The students were beaten up heavily in the police lockup. And in a very brutal manner, the movement was suppressed. And now basically, Hindustan Republic Association said that and one of its aim was, until and unless we pick up arms against these Britishers are not going to stop any violent activities against us. So they picked up arms against the Britishers. Then, we want Federal Republic of India, like which was called as United States of India. Now basically, federal means we have a center, we have a state. And what is true federalism? True federalism means center is strong in comparison to the state. And basically, republic means here, Like we have the right to choose our own dignitaries. For example, India is a truly republic nation because dignitaries in India are chosen by the people. For example, we choose our MPs and MLAs. Our MPs and MLAs choose our President of India. So indirectly, the President of India, who is representing the will of the people and is regarded as the first citizen of the nation, has been chosen by the people of India indirectly. So we want the nation which is truly republic, and we have the authority to choose our own officers, our own political executive, our own permanent executive. This was the second major aim. Voting on adult franchise. Like prior to this, we have discussed this. There was passage of Montego Chelmsford, and there was one clause in the Montego Chelmsford reforms basically, which said person who was having a taxable income had the authority to vote. Now, this was a sort of discrimination. Suppose if I'm a poor farmer and I'm not able to pay a stipulated amount of tax, so it does not mean that I do not have the right to choose my ministers. Isn't that so? So there should be voting on adult franchisee basis. There should be a stipulated criteria like the age criteria for voting and not the economic criteria. And voting should be free to everyone, irrespective of the religion, irrespective of the caste, subcaste, creed or gender. So this was one of the demand. One of the activities in which Hindustan Republic Association was involved was Kakori conspiracy case. And Kakori conspiracy case is a very famous case in the history of modern India and in the history of India's freedom struggle. This entire incident has been mentioned basically in one of the movies as well, Rang De Basanti, if you have seen that movie. Now, what is the incident all about? Listen to me very carefully. Now, there was a train which was moving from Lucknow to Saharanpur. Now, this train was basically carrying certain arms and ammunition. It was carrying a certain amount of money. It was carrying government documents. As I have previously told you, our revolutionaries usually conspired with the military people. Our revolutionaries running secret society so that they can be well informed about the activities of the Britishers. Now, there were few leaders like Ashfaq Ullah Khan, Ram Prasad Bismil, Durga Bhabi. Now, they came to know that a train is moving from basically Lucknow to Saharanpur. Okay. And there is a small station which is called as Kakori station. It's a small village just away from Lucknow. Okay. Now, we are going to loot the entire train. We are going to burn down the government documents. We are going to take the cash. We are going to take the arms and ammunition. Now, the entire information was provided to the leaders of HRA by the secret societies that were running in various parts of India, and specifically the secret societies of UP and Bihar. Now, entire plan was planned in a very strategic manner. Now, the train was looted at a place called as Kakori. And now various people were involved here, like Swarna Singh, who was uncle of Bhagat Singh ji, Ram Prasad Bismil, Ashfaq Ullah Khan, Durga Bhabi, then Roshan Singh, Chandrasekhar Azad, and various other leaders were participant in the movement. And here they looted down the train. Now what happened basically, some of the local person conspired with the Britishers and provided the information to the Britishers that Kakori train has been looted. Like basically, what usually the revolutionaries do? Immediately after conducting a raid, what did they do? They cut the telegraph line so that there couldn't be any sort of communication between the British officials. They cut the railway track so that no police could be sent behind them. Now, what happened basically? Some person conspired against the revolutionary and provided to the Britishers. Now, at this point of time, when they provided information to the Britishers, the entire plan got unearthed and various leaders were arrested, like Swarna Singh, then Ram Prasad Bismil, Rajendra Lahiri, and so on. And it is said that they were taken to the court properly and trial was being conducted against them. And Ram Prasad Bismil saw a trial as an opportunity to sensitize the people of India, basically, against the tyrannical British rule. So, one of the poems which is written by Bismil Azimabadi, this poem was popularized by Ram Prasad Bismil. And when it is said that, when these people were presented in the court in front of a judge, okay, when they were presented in the court in front of a judge, they used to recite this poem, which created a patriotic zeal among the nationalists of India and specifically among the youth of India. And the poem was, Sar Faroshi ki tamanna ab hamare dil mein hai. Dekhna hai zor kitna bazue katil mein hai. This poem is actually written by Bismil Azimabadi. And the poem has been popularized by Ram Prasad Bismil during the trial. The poem simply says that, we are ready for martyrdom. We are ready to die for our motherland. We are ready to die for our rights. And we are going to check how much brutal suppression are you going to carry on us. Such a sensitizing poem it is. Now various other, lawyers came to protect these people. Like Govind Vallabh Pant, Mohanlal Saxena, Ajit Prasad Jain, Gopinath Srivastav. They tried to protect these revolutionaries. But finally, Ram Prasad Bismilji, few revolutionaries were transported to life. Few revolutionaries had to face life imprisonment. And Ram Prasad Bismilji was hanged at Gorakhpur jail. And even before dying, he repeated the same poem. That is Sar Faroshi ki Tamanna. So these were the revolutionaries who conducted the Kakori conspiracy case. My friends, did you understand Hindustan Republic Association? Please let me know. Yes, good evening, Raghupati. Good evening, Monalisha. Yes, guys, wasn't that interesting? Kakori conspiracy case. Yes, Jayashree. Okay. Now let's talk about Hindustan Socialist Republic Association. Now listen to me very carefully. Now, the major and the key role in founding the Hindustan Socialist Republic Association was by Bhagat Singh and Chandrasekhar Azad. And majorly the credit goes to Bhagat Singh Ji. And later on, it was joined by Chandrasekhar Azad. Okay. Now I'll give you a very small example. Initially, Chandrasekhar Azad associated himself with Hindustan Republic Association. As I've told you, Chandrasekhar Azad ji was also one of the leaders basically in Kakori conspiracy case. Now it is said that Chandrasekhar Azad's original name is Chandrasekhar Tiwari. Listen to this. It's very good, new and informative something. His original name is Chandrasekhar Tiwari. And he was born at a place called as, he was born in a village which is located in Ali Rajpur district of Madhya Pradesh. Now, he was just 15 to 16 years old when he participated in the non-cooperation movement. Like when M.K. Gandhi initiated non-cooperation movement, he urged all the revolutionaries to stay calm. He urged all the revolutionaries to be a part of a non-violent struggle. And on the insistence of M.K. Gandhi, every revolutionary gave up violence and became a participant of the non-cooperation movement. Chandrasekhar Azad ji was just 15 years old when he was a participant in the non-cooperation movement. And as I've told you, Britishers came up heavily on the Satyagrahis. They followed a policy of a brutal suppression and every Satyagrahi was beaten up heavily. Now, when the Britishers caught this 15-year-old boy, he was taken into the jail and he was beaten up with a whip Do you know whip? In Hindi, it is called as chabuk. Now, he was beaten up with a whip. And he was produced in the front of a judge. Okay. Now, judge, before starting the case, asked him, what is your name? His name is Chandrasekhar Tiwari. And what did he reply? What is your name? He said, my name is Azad. Azad means free-minded. What is your father's name? He said, my father's name is Swatantra. Swatantra means independent. He said, what is your address? He said, my address is jail. So, in fact, district magistrate, district judge was very shocked by the, what we say, valor and the courage showed by this boy. Then later on, he got himself transferred at Jhansi. And Jhansi was made, Chandrasekhar Azad ji made Jhansi a small hub. Okay, like near Jhansi, there is a place called as Orcha. And in the forest of Orcha, he used to carry on the practice of rifle shooting. He used to carry out the gun practice basically. Okay. Then later on, when he met Bhagat Singh ji, he got associated with Hindustan Republic Association. But when majority of the leaders of Hindustan Republic Association were either hanged to death or were what we say sent to jail as a life imprisonment. Okay. So what happened basically? He got associated with Bhagat Singh ji and formed an organization called as Hindustan Socialist Republic Association. Okay. Like it is said, basically, such an exemplary role being played by Chandrasekhar Azad ji. Such an exemplary role played by Chandrasekhar Azad ji that basically there was one person called as Veer Bhadra. Okay. Now, Veer Bhadra, he was a very close associate of Azad ji. Okay. But he still conspired against Azad ji and provided entire information to the Britishers about the whereabouts of Azad ji. And Britishers started chasing Azad ji. And Azad ji was now in a place called as Allahabad. Okay. Which is also referred at a place called as Alfred Park. Okay. Now, it is said that when they were chasing Azad ji, now it is said that He succumbed lot of injuries, and when one bullet was left, he killed himself. And the reason for killing himself was that I want to die for my motherland. I want to die for my nations, but not from the hands of traitors, not from the hands of alien rule or the suppressors. And he attained martyrdom. It is said that the pistol that he used for shooting against the Britishers is still kept presently in Allahabad Museum. So, he played a very dynamic role in the formation. Okay. He played a very dynamic role in the formation of Hindustan Socialist Republic Association. Now, the leaders in this association from Punjab were Bhagat Singh, Sukhdev and Bhagwati Charan Bora. And the leaders from UP were Shiv Verma, Jaydev Kapoor and Bijoy Kumar Sinha. And with the passage of time, more leaders started getting associated with it. Now, their objective were to establish socialist state in India. Okay. Now, in socialist state, people have their own rights. People are free in complete manner. Like in socialist state, the state is completely republic in nature. State is completely secular in nature. But majority of the key industries are being owned by the state. And state work for the welfare of the society. So this was one of the objectives of Hindustan Socialist Republic Association. And the other important objective was to sensitize the masses against the Gandhian method of non-violence. I'll give you a very small example. Throughout basically non-cooperation movement, it was completely based upon satyagraha and non-violence. Now, one of the key features, one of the key quality of a satyagrahi is to resist the non-violence, is to even if somebody is conducting violence against you, you shouldn't be violent towards that person. This is one of an important quality of a satyagrahi. Now, at this point of time, it is said that very brutal policy of suppression was followed by the Britishers during the non-cooperation movement. And there was a small incident at a place called as Chauri Chaura in Gorakhpur. Like it is said that people were peacefully protesting in front of the liquor shop. And Britishers, now they did lathi charge on the people. in a violent manner, they tried to suppress the people who were protesting in a peaceful manner. Now, these mob got angered and they killed 22 policemen by burning a station at a place called as Chauri Chaura, which is located near Gorakhpur. Now, basically, these people, M.K. Gandhi came to know about this and immediately he took back the movement. Now, various people criticize this act. Various historians, various national leaders criticize this act. And the reason behind that was, when a violent suppression was followed by the Britishers, M.K. Gandhi did not take the movement back. But when Britishers came up heavily, when Indian people became violent, why did the movement was taken back when it was so successful? So, it is said that one of the key objectives was to arouse the consciousness among the futility of Gandhian rule or among the futility of Gandhian method of non-violence. Now, what was one of their activities being conducted? Listen to me. This is called as Lahore conspiracy case. Now, basically, Simon Commission was to arrive in India. One of the act was Montego Chelmsford reform. Okay, it is said that Montego Chelmsford reform has one of the clause. And one of the clause basically says that after 10 years, we are going to appoint one commission. And that commission would be reviewing the working of Montego Chelmsford reform after 10 years. So a commission was appointed, which was called as Simon Commission. And it was all white commission. No single Indian member was involved in the commission. What happened? Everywhere the Simon Commission went, it was greeted with black flag. And their slogan was raised, Simon, go back. Now, everywhere, Pune, Vijayawada, Bombay, Lahore, everywhere, Calcutta and so on. Now, when the commission reached Punjab, a protest movement was conducted by Lala Lajpat Rai ji. Now, what happened basically, Lala Lajpat Rai ji was protesting against the arrival of Simon Commission and British came up brutally on the protesters. Lala Lajpat Rai ji had to succumb lot of injuries on his chest and due to this, basically he died. Besides him was Bhagat Singh ji and Bhagat Singh ji wanted to take the revenge basically against this act of the Britishers and he decided to, what we say, assassinate the police chief Scott. And he did a plan. And the plan was, now when the police chief Scott will arrive, assassinate him in the public. Okay? And the plan, the entire strategy was being planned out by Bhagat Singh ji, Rajguru ji and Sukhdev ji. What happened basically, at the point of time, they missed the shot on Scott and they landed up, shooting or assassinating DSP, whose name was J.P. Saunders, John P. Saunders, and they assassinated him. Bhagat Singh ji fled from Lahore. Okay? And they tried to carry out their activities in a similar manner in other parts. Now, Bhagat Singh ji wanted to sensitize the masses. And for that, he needs to get arrested and use court as a medium and use trial as a medium to sensitize the masses. Now, he purposely threw a bomb in the Central Legislative Assembly and there were against the passage of two bills, Trade Dispute Bill and Public Safety Bill. Both the bills we are going to discuss later in the later part of the chapter. So against the passage of these two bills, basically he threw a bomb in the Central Legislative Assembly. Bomb was purposely made harmless. Bomb will not make any harm to any person. But the purpose of throwing bomb was one thing. That at least due to the sound of the bomb, Britishers will come to know that we people are angry on you and at least listen to our demands now. And immediately after throwing the bomb in the lobby of Central Legislative Assembly, he shouted a slogan that is Inqilab Zindabad. And immediately he was arrested. When he was arrested, basically, it is said that he was sent to jail for Lahore conspiracy case or Saunders murder case. Now, when he went to jail, basically, Bhagat Singh ji, Rajguru ji and Sukhdev ji were sent to the jail. Now, when they reached the jail, they saw that the condition of the prisoners was deteriorating. they were living in a very derogatory condition, very unhygienic condition. The sanitation was very poor. Okay. Now it is said that for the rights of the prisoners, he started hunger strike in the jail. And the hunger strike continued till 65 to 66 days. It is said that nobody even had a single drop of water for approximately around 2 months. Nobody had an iota of food for approximately around 2 months. If you see or if you read what we say about Bhagat Singh Ji, you will come to know that Britishers were beating up them. The Britishers were beating up our prisoners. They were beating up our revolutionaries in the prison to have food compulsorily. Now, they used to catch, a person used to catch their jaw and put water into that. But our revolutionaries were hell-bent for our motherland. And finally, on the 64th day, Jatin Das became the first martyr of Mother India from the revolutionary side. Not the first martyr, we can say, but the martyr in the jail, basically, who was conducting hunger strike. And immediately, on 23rd March 1931, Bhagat Singh Ji, Rajguru Ji and Sukhdev Ji were hanged in Lahore. And this event in the history of modern India, in the history of India's freedom struggle, is referred as Operation Trojan Horse. Now, there was another person whose name was Hari Krishna Talwar. And Hari Krishna Talwar Ji was very much inspired by the philosophy of Bhagat Singh Ji and other revolutionary like Azad Ji. Okay. Now, he attempted to kill the governor of Punjab, whose name was Geoffrey Montmorency. Okay. Now, what happened basically, Geoffrey Montmorency was coming out from Lahore Hall after addressing a session. And as soon as he was coming out of the Lahore Hall by conducting a session, he shot Geoffrey Montmorency, but it did not hurt him. And his bodyguard, a police officer named as Chanan Singh, was killed in that. Immediately, basically, he was what we say arrested. After arrest, a trial was being conducted against Hari Krishna Talwar Ji, and he was hanged in 1931 at Miawala Jail, which is in West Punjab. Okay, so these are the activities associated with Hindustan Socialist Republic Association. My friends, did you get the points? Please let me know. Yes, Why I'm Atheist, Dipesh, it's a book written by Bhagat Singh Ji. Yes, Shrikant, book written by Bhagwati Charan Vora is Philosophy of Bomb. Perfect. Yes, thanks a lot, Apurva. Thanks for the compliment. Yes, Harmeet, Bhagat Singh Ji was basically used quote as a medium to sensitize the masses. Because through quote, basically there would be print media and things would be written. Basically, it is said that things would be written in the newspaper and people will come to know about this act and people will develop that enthusiasm, that patriotic zeal. Hope so, Harmeet, I have answered your question. Yes, guys, please let me know. Did you understand the concept? Shrikant, basically the word socialist was added by Bhagat Singh Ji. Okay. Now, let us understand about Gopinath Saha. There was a question in the exam basically, who tried an assassination attempt on Charles Taggart. Okay. So, it was Gopinath Saha. Now, Gopinath Saha, this I wanted to cover in the Bengal, but I forgot to cover in Bengal, so I'm covering it here. Gopinath Saha, basically, he was a revolutionary leader from Bengal. And he was associated with the secret societies in the region of Bengal. And now, he wanted to assassinate Calcutta police commissioner, whose name was Charles Taggart. Okay? Because Charles Taggart, right from the start, had followed a very brutal policy of suppression against the Indian leaders. Okay. against the Indian leaders. So what did he do basically? Now, he was carrying, like basically he was observing the activities of Charles de Gaulle. Now, he wanted to assassinate Charles de Gaulle, but mistakenly he assassinated some other person. Now, he reached the office of Charles de Gaulle and he wanted to assassinate him. But there was one businessman whose name was Ernest Day. He had come to meet Charles de Gaulle. He was a civilian, basically British civilian. He had come to meet Charles de Gaulle. Now, basically, it is said that he just shot at Charles de Gaulle, but the bullet hit basically whom? It hit that civilian. And immediately he was arrested. And after that, a trial being conducted, and finally he was hanged in 1924. So this is majorly about Gopinath Saha. Okay. Yes, Harmeet, that is why he threw the bomb. Yes, Dipesh, Hindustan Republic Association was formed by some other person, that is Ram Prasad Bismil and his associate. Okay, and Hindustan Socialist Republic Association was formed by Bhagat Singh Ji and Chandrasekhar Azad. Now, Chandrasekhar Azad was initially a part of Hindustan Republic Association. But after Kakori conspiracy case, many of the leaders were being arrested. And now later on, now the only leader of major leader of Hindustan Republic Association left was Chandrasekhar Azad. So later on, Hindustan Republic Association was merged with Hindustan Socialist Republic Association of Bhagat Singh. Hope so the point is clear. Dipesh. Yes, it's okay, Monisha. Now, let's talk about the Kanpur Bolshevik conspiracy case. Okay. Now, M.N. Roy, he founded Mexican Communist Party. Now, by this, communism wasn't quite vogue in India. Okay. And we have discussed about the various labor movements that was being carried out in India. So, communism was quite vogue in India by now. And M.N. Roy was one of the communist leaders who came up by this time. Now, basically, M.N. Roy was conspiring with the other communist leaders and the other communist countries to overthrow the British tyrannical rules in India. And the communist leaders became very famous about this act because media, specifically the newspaper, started publishing against them. Okay? Now, it was said that their only way they thought that they wanted to create an armed rebellion in India. And the rebellion should be created in a very secret manner so that British could not anticipate about what is happening. And British could not anticipate the situation basically. So what happened basically at this point of time? Now, this entire plot, which was conducted by M.N. Roy, Britishers came to know about this. Okay. And now for the first, it is said that people came to know about the communism for the first time. People came to know about we need to fight for our rights. We need to pick up arms against the British government. So now at this point of time, various leaders were arrested. And in fact, M.N. Roy, he was also arrested in 1931. So this entire conspiracy is called as Kanpur Bolshevik conspiracy case. It is called as Bolshevik because it was inspired by the Russian Revolution ideology. So this was being conducted by M.N. Roy. Also, the points are clear, my friends. Please let me know. Yes, guys, please let me know. Now, let's talk about South India. Let's talk about Bharat Mata Association. Guys, yesterday I had discussed Bharat Mata Society. Today, I am discussing Bharat Mata Association. Both of them are quite different. Okay. Now, Bharat Mata Association was founded by Neelkant Brahmachari and Vanchi Iyer in Madras Presidency. And it was a secret presidency which was running in the region of South India and specifically in the region of Tamil Nadu. Now, it is said that Vanchi Iyer was involved in the murder of District Magistrate of Tirunelveli, Mr. Ash. Now, what is that basically? Let us understand. Okay. Now, Vanchi Iyer and Neelkanth Brahmachari had decided to murder, to assassinate the district collector of Tirunelveli, whose name was Ash. Now, they were continuously observing the activities of Ashay. Now, what happened basically, this person, Ashay, was once moving from a place in Tirunelveli, okay, that is from Manichayachi to a place called as Kodaikanal. Now, first of all, where he was staying, he had to change two trains. Okay, listen to the concept. Now, from first place, he wanted to go to another place. From there, he had to deboard this train and board the other train. Okay, now his wife had arrived from Ireland. Okay, and now his wife and he boarded a train basically at a place called as, they boarded a train in Tirunelveli Junction. Okay, now from Tirunelveli Junction, they reached to a place called as Manichayachi. And now they were waiting for another train that will be going to Kodaikanal. Now, when they were waiting for another train, two people arrived. And these two people, one was like, he was completely in a tuft dress. And the other person was wearing a dhoti. Now, immediately he took out a Browning pistol and shot basically Mr. Ash in his chest. And immediately Mr. Ash died. They did not shoot his wife, the lady. And this person, Vanchi Iyer, Vanchi Nathan, he went into the railway toilet and basically he hid himself. But later on it was found that he had shot himself, basically. So, Vanchi Iyer later committed suicide. And the major reason behind that, he wanted to die as a martyr and not from the hands of the Britishers. So, basically it is said that he shot himself. And this event in the history of India's freedom struggle is referred as assassination of Mr. Ashay. And this was carried out by a leader called as Vanchi Iyer, who was associated with Bharat Mata Association. And my friends, I have been telling you, Bharat Mata Association is different from Bharat Mata Society. Hope so the assassination of Mr. Ashay is clear. Please let me know. Okay, now let's talk about the activities that were going on in abroad, in foreign countries basically. Okay, so one of the major party was Ghadar party. Now Ghadar is an Urdu word basically, which means revolt or rebellion. And the party was majorly founded by Sohan Singh Bhakna and Lala Haridayal. Now let us go to the genesis of this. Its headquarters was located in San Francisco, that is USA. Now it is said that Lala Haridayal was initially in India till 1909, but later on he moved to Paris in France. In Paris, he learned the techniques of bomb making and got associated with a journal called as Vande Mataram. One of the techniques for sensitizing the people and specifically the youth at that time was through newspaper, through journal, through pamphlet. And the revolutionaries were sensitized in this manner. So Lala Haridayal ji got associated with the, what we say, Vande Mataram newspaper. Then later it is said that he got indulged in trade union activities in San Francisco. And later on he formed Pacific West Hindustan Association along with Sohan Singh Bhakna, which later on came to be called as Ghadar Party. So initially he formed Pacific India Association, West Hindustan Association, which was later converted into Ghadar Party. Now, there were many Sikh who had migrated to places like France, who had migrated to places like Canada, who had migrated to places like US for employment opportunity. And basically, these were basically peasants who were involved here, or they were ex-soldiers who had moved to some other foreign country for employment opportunity. And they had settled in foreign nation itself. Now, they were completely willing to overthrow the British rule in India. And now basically it is said that Ghadar Party was formed and various other leaders were also associated with the Ghadar Party. Now, what were the programs of Ghadar Party? Similar programs were being carried out by the members of Ghadar Party, which was being carried out by the revolutionaries in India. First was organized assassination of officials. Like those unpopular officials who were known for brutal suppression of the movement, who were against the Indian rule, who were continuously humiliating and insulting the Indians in their motherland. Now, assassination should be conducted on these officials. Then, publish revolutionary and anti-imperialist literature. I'll give you a very simple example. Like Lala Lajpat Rai ji was inspired by Mazzini, an Italian thinker Mazzini. So, in that way, in similar manner, like revolutionary literature was popularized at that time. Like the literature of Lenin, like the literature of Karl Marx, literature of Mazzini was popularized because it was full of revolutionary zeal and thoughts. So, this was one of the major aims of the Ghadar party. Now, another important aim was to work among the troops that were working abroad. I'll give you a very simple example. Like there were many Indian soldiers who were also working in the foreign nations. Like India was not only the colony of British. There were many other British colonies. Okay. And many Indian soldiers were working as a part of the British Indian Army in many other colonies of Britain. So these people or the members of Ghadar party started conspiring with the soldiers, with the army men, so that they could get information about the activities of the Britishers in various countries. And they will provide information to the revolutionaries in India about that. And basically, to promote the movement simultaneously in all the British colonies was another important aim. Because by now, every country was trying to liberate itself. Like Ireland, I had given you an example basically. Then Japan, it had overthrown the rule of Russia. It had defeated Russian army basically. So every country was moving through a democratic process. And every country has the right to remain, to keep its sovereignty intact. So one of the major aim was to free all the British colonies. And this was being what we say one of the important objective of the Ghadar party. And basically their slogan, their tagline was Angrezi Raj Ka Dushman. I repeat, their slogan or their tagline was Angrezi Raj Ka Dushman. That is enemy of the British rule. Okay, next comes Swadesh Sevak Sangh. It was started in Vancouver, which is located in Canada. Okay, like it was similar to India House, which is located in London. We are going to discuss about that. It was started by G.D. Kumar. Okay, and he also started a Gurmukhi newspaper called as Swadesh Sevak, which advocated social reform as well as rise against the British rule. Now, Swadesh Sevak, the meaning of this is we are Sevak. We are the servants of our country. And we are ready to sacrifice for our country at any cost. And for that case, the people need to be sensitized against the British rule. People need to know about the tyrannical British rule basically. Getting the points clear? So Swadesh Sevak Sangh was started in Vancouver. And my friends, time and again, there have been questions in the UPSC exam about the revolutionary associations that were running in abroad. Like which association was running in San Francisco, which was running in London, which was running in Berlin, which was running in Canada, Vancouver. There have been direct questions in the UPSC prelims exam in the form of match the following. So hope so you understood Swadesh Sevak Sangh. Then United India House was formed by Taraknath Das at a place called Seattle in USA. Okay. And it worked in a similar manner like the other associations. Okay. Now, India House. India House was founded by, it was founded in London by Shyamji Krishna Verma. And Shyamji Krishna Verma had started his own newspaper to sensitize the revolutionary and specifically the youth. And that newspaper was Indian Sociologist. Okay. To sensitize the Indian youth against a tyrannical British rule. Now what happened basically, India House was started as a hostel for the students. Like there were many students who were going to London for gaining higher education. So India House lodged these students as a part of the hostel. But later on, it became revolutionary in nature. It started training these youth in bomb making, in arms and ammunition. Now, India House leaders were also involved in a conspiracy called as Indo-German Plot or Hindu-German Conspiracy. I had discussed about this conspiracy yesterday, guys. I'll discuss this again. Now, basically, during the World War I, Germany was on opposite side of Britain. Okay. Now, Indian revolutionaries conspired with a German office, basically. Getting the points there, they conspired with a German office and said that, please provide us all the information about the Britishers. And now Germany wanted, like Germany was completely opposed to Britain. And now it wanted to weaken the confidence of Britain by starting a revolutionary movement in India when Britain will be involved in World War I. Are you getting the points clear? When Britain is fighting with Germany in the World War I, Germany, with the help of Indian revolutionary, is going to stimulate a movement in India. This will weaken the confidence of Britain. So, and at this point of time, Germany also said that Indian revolutionaries that we are going to provide you training, we are going to provide you bombs, we are going to provide you arms and ammunition. Okay? Now, majority of the Gadar leaders were involved in Hindu-German conspiracy. Now, Britishers came to know about this plot. And when Britishers came to know about this plot, majority of the leaders were arrested. Majority of them were hanged. Majority of them were transported for life. So this is referred as Hindu-German conspiracy in the history of India's freedom struggle. Indian League was again started by Taraknath Das in USA. India Independence League was started by Lala Haridayal and Birendra in Berlin. Please remember, these are factual in nature. The way, the pattern and the methodology of working of majority of the associations that were operated in abroad were same. Getting the points clear, my friends? Yes, guys, did you get the points still here? Please let me know. No, Satya, Gadar movie is not at all based on this. Gadar movie is quite different. Okay. It's a party name, Satya. Okay. Yes, Dipesh, we are going to discuss Komagata Maru incident basically. We are going to discuss in the next session. Okay. Let's talk about the Indian League 1942. Now, Indian League was founded by Ras Bihari Bose. And Ras Bihari Bose wanted to conduct, he wanted to overthrow the British rule in India by conspiring with the other nations. Now, he was conspiring, he formed Indian Independence League along with Jawaharlal Nehru. And later on, he was also, he played a very key role in the formation of Indian National Army for liberation of India. My friends, Indian National Army founded by Ras Bihari Bose is different from the foundation of Subhas Chandra Bose. We are going to discuss about that as well. Okay. Now, he wanted to take the help of other nations to conspire against the British rule or to overthrow the tyrannical British rule. So, he majorly conspired with Japan. Okay. Now, basically, he said, Japan was getting close towards India. Getting the points clear, and it was trying to help out India in overthrowing the tyrannical British rule. Now, few people doubted the intentions of Ras Bihari Bose ji in a manner that, like they said that, Japan, we are not clear about the aims of Japan. Quite possible that it will help us in gaining independence from the British, but later on Japan will colonize us. So basically, many people felt that at this point of time, we should carry on the movement in foreign countries and in India rather than taking help from the other countries. But still, Indian League was formed in 1942. Hope so the points are clear, sir. Friends. Yes, Mohan Singh was a commander-in-chief of the army. Like the major role in the formation was played by Subhas Chandra Bose, like he took the leadership later on. But initially it was formed by Ras Bihari Bose. Okay. But the commander in chief of the army that was created was Mohan Singh. Hope so, Apurva, I have made your question clear. Yes, Dipesh, Ras Bihari Bose was also involved in the assassination of Lord Harding when he was moving in the Chandni Chowk. Yes. Yes, Dipesh, correct. Now let's talk about Berlin Committee for India's Independence. Now let me give you a very simple what we say understanding about the Zimmermann plan. Now Zimmermann, he was working in the German office. Now what happened basically, Germany did not wanted USA to enter into the World War I. Because if USA is going to enter into the World War I, it is going to support Britain. So what did Zimmermann do? Zimmermann planned with Mexico that if USA is going to support Britain in the World War I, the another North American country, which is Mexico, will support us. And this plan was jolted by a German office secretary whose name was Zimmermann. Okay. Now, basically, Mexico, and this is also called as Zimmermann telegraph. Okay. Now, Mexico, Germany, and various other countries are going to help out India against the British tyrannical rule by basically providing arms and ammunition to the revolutionary. Okay. So, basically, Berlin Committee for India Independence was started by Virendranath Chattopadhyay. And was started with the help of the German consulate, and they started mobilizing the Indian revolutionaries abroad. Hope so the points are clear. And they started sending these revolutionaries to different places in India and in the world so that they could gather information about the British tyrannical rule. Getting the points clear? Like one such mission was sent under Raja Mahendra Pratap Singh, okay, to Kabul to organize a government there. And so that we can easily watch the activities of the Britishers that are happening in India as well as in the countries around India. So that we can sensitize the masses against a tyrannical British rule. Hope so. Berlin Committee is clear, my friends. Please let me know. Yes, guys. These are the newspaper and journals which are quite important from the exam perspective. You need to remember the names of the publishers, because time and again there have been questions in the exam about the publisher of the revolutionary newspapers. So it is quite factual in nature. You need to memorize this, guys. Hope so the points are clear, guys. So please, what we said, these newspapers are quite important from exam perspective. And time and again, there have been questions on these revolutionary newspapers. Okay, guys. So please memorize these newspaper. Okay. So this is the end of today's session, guys. Hope so the points are clear. Did you understand each and everything, each and every conspiracy, each and every fact, each and every concept? Okay. Okay, guys, on Monday, we are going to come up or we are going to conclude the revolutionaries part, and we are going to come up with revolutionaries part 3. So I'll be concluding it on Monday. Okay, priorly, I'm also informing you one thing, guys, like those students who have missed out ancient India can watch my lectures on ancient India on the English platform itself. But also I'm conducting a session on ancient India. It's a part of a marathon session, which is being conducted by 3 teachers of history or educators of history on the main channel, that is Unacademy's Let's Crack UPSC CSC on Friday. And it would be at basically my lecture would start, my session would start at 10:30 a.m. It would be a marathon session of 4 to 4.5 hours basically on ancient India. And after that, the other educators will continue with medieval and modern on the main channel, guys. So guys, if you have missed out and if you're preparing for this year's prelim, please be present on Friday as well, guys, on 18th of September. Okay. Yes, Jayashree, we are going to take a separate session on all the Congress sessions and the president of the International Congress and the activities majorly. We are also going to take a separate session on treaties and war. We are going to take a separate session on the after treaties and war, viceroys. Okay. Monisha, it would be on bilingual platform. Okay, that would be 18 September would be on bilingual platform. Okay, guys. So, yes, guys, if you like my lectures, please use my code AKOUS. I repeat, please use my code AKOUS. Thank you and have a very nice day.